Yo, yo, yo. CPA Strength here. This video is going to how to motivate people. Be motivated. So here, how to pass the CPA exam. Get motivated. You're motivated, right? I know. It's just not that simple. I wish it was that simple. This is the first video that I've made that I've wanted that the whole purpose of this video is to hold someone's motivation, to motivate somebody. In essence, it's for a particular person, but this could, you know who you are, and I really would like to say thank you to this person's friend, because I got a comment and it said, hey, CPA Strength, your videos are giving me life, which is freaking awesome, because a lot of pressure. Can I handle it? I might have to grind. Why you grinding on? Because I need the money. You know, I know what it is to not feel a lot of life. You know, I know what it is for something, anything to give you life. It could be weird or not normal for someone, like that gives you life. Like that's not normal, but like it doesn't matter. You said my videos give you life and that your friend is losing motivation for the CPA exam and he's trying to be a CPA in Florida. So I'm like, oh, and then you're like, you probably don't have time to respond. You probably won't respond to this or something. So I'm like, here, I'm making a video for you the next day. Yo, what's up? CPA Strength sliding in through. Like, what up with though? I really have gone through points where no one wanted to listen to a word I had to say. So for now to be in a position to be able to motivate people, plural, especially one person, maybe your friend as well, so two people. Of course I'll do that. I mean, it's not that easy to say, be motivated. I found myself being a motivational speaker on these YouTube videos. I've come to the terms with that. I do motivate and inspire people. The larger my audience, the more people I can inspire and motivate. So that's awesome. And I love the feeling I get from that. Yo, what up? CPA Strength here. I have to do a motivational video this morning. I think it's my first motivational video that I'm doing. So I know my hair's a mess. But anyways, I guess I'll just tell my story because that's what I usually do. So it's like, Maybe someone's like, no, you've been doing motivational speaking this whole time. But like, I was just telling my story. So yeah, man. You know what it is. CPI Strength. Let's go to the video. Roll up this beautiful bean footage. Chef Boy RJ DM me, baby. Let's go. CPI Drizzle. CPI Strength. Strongest CPA in the game. Who do you know more stronger than this? Let's go. How to stay motivated in the CPA exam. I've already told in another video, so if you're, you know, I've already told a point where I was 0 for 2, I failed two different CPA exams. You have to pass four of them in an 18-month span, so it's very, very hard. There's only about 500,000 CPA, Certified Public Accountants in America. It's very, very prestigious. It's a premium license. Okay, it's a premium, and I'm not a bad, it's a select club, and then you have to actually get someone who's in the club already to sign off on you and say, yo, I want them in the club. So I'm not ashamed to say that this is a hard test. It's a premium. I know how much blood, sweat, and tears I put into this thing, and so I know that if I see another CPA that they put in just an insane amount of dedication, or they're so insanely smart, or whatever the reason that they passed this, and they're special as well. So they're welcome to the club in open arms, and I know they're smart, and I want to hear what they have to say. So this is what I'm saying. I know in my case, because I need the money. I never did nothing with my life. I always gave up. I never did nothing. Whenever I met some resistance, I just gave up. You know, academically, sports. Oh, I can't be the best. I'm not even going to try. You know, the only thing I wanted to be really good at was running them streets. And I guess if you look back, I really wasn't that great at that either. So, you know, whatever point you're on in the CPA exam, you're close. Because once you pass the CPA exam, it's so big and so extraordinary that you don't really have to do much after that. I mean, it's just a stepping stone for me. What I'm saying is, it's so big, everyone says, wow, he's a CPA. Why is he a CPA in the business world and whatever? You know, you get a lot of credibility. I mean, I don't have to do CPA. Think about it. I don't do CPA stuff. I make YouTube videos. You don't need a CPA license for that, but everyone knows I have a CPA license, and I can go into a boardroom, or I can make some money. So what I'm saying is, you're close, man. You don't have to actually do your CPA license, but just finish it out. Just stick with the CPA license. So in another video, in a different video, I've talked about, I talked about when I was 0-2 and I changed my study habits. I stopped worrying about how much time other people studied, and I just studied as much as I possibly could. And that was the biggest thing. And I stopped counting how many hours of studying I was doing and just studied as much as I could. And that was the biggest thing. And then I reeled off 3 straight victories. So you'd say, oh, story's over, CPA exam, wow, that was a good triumph. No, more struggle for me. So here's, I don't think I've talked about this part of the struggle in a video before. So this is new stuff for any viewer, any long-time viewer, new-time viewer, anybody who's here for the motivation. Why am I grinding on them, huh? Because I need the money, yo. Little boy Blue, because he needed the money. Yo, why you grinding on him, JD? Because I need the money. I'm a little bit offended you'd even ask, to be quite frank and honest. Let's see how fat your boy. I ended up taking the I ended up failing two exams. I ended up passing the next 3. Ended up getting a job, a first real job. You know, I say a first real job. I've got paid jobs before, but it was under a CPA. So I just had to work this place for a year and have this CPA sign off on me. And I just had to pass one more exam, the FAR exam, the beast, the hardest of the 4 exams. I'd already failed it the very, very first time. Hey, you know how I said my other video that I never collabed with any other YouTube, I never had any other collabs? I'm sorry, I've done plenty of collabs appearances by my in IRL, my in real life friends. I'm sorry, y'all. And Ty Sticks, you've done 2 mukbangs with me. You've had to sit in a room with me and be on camera. So I did a tax season at this. I failed it with a. You could do whatever, B. 73. Need a 75 to pass. Need to pass all 4 in an 18-month window. So then I reeled off 3 straight victories. So I had a year before any of the victories expired, because you have to do it in a year and a half. You have to pass all 4 exams. So I passed 3 in like 6 months, or 4 or 5 months. So I just had one more to pass in, as we'll say, a year. So it's looking good. Well, failing need stay with a pound of weed. I found out I got this job at the CPA firm. I didn't start because I was for a tax preparation position. So really, tax season starts in January, February. I got the job in by late November. So I had a month of not much to do. I had one more exam to pass. I said, oh man, I'll study for the FAR exam. That's the one, that's the beast, that's the one I have left. I took it the first time around, the very first time, and I got a 73 on it. So all I need is a 75 to pass. I just reeled off 3 straight victories. I just found a job. I'll take it. I'm going to do this, right? Everything's going my way. So yeah, so I studied for it. I started the new job in January. It was stressful. I didn't take the day off before. Anyways, I took the exam, the FAR exam. I got a 73. So I wasn't working, and the first time I took the exam, I got a 73. I failed another exam, passed three exams. Now this exam, my sixth time taking the CPA exam, second time taking FAR, I failed with a 73. I continued working this job, did tax season, didn't really study too much. Then after tax season, I took the exam, I believe in June or July again. Not sure. So this time the clock was ticking. I had about maybe 8 months left before any of the credits started expiring. It's over a year. We the ones loaded fight, sunglasses on at night. Motherfucker, this is trash life. I had been working at this place for 6 months now. I've been telling everybody, you know, all of my family that, you know, I've been on this journey, it seemed like forever, with the CPA exams. I had this job now. Why am I, you know, like, what's going on? Anyways, first time I took FAR exam, 73. Failed tax exam, passed three exams. Passed tax, passed reg, passed audit. Took FAR again in January, failed with another 73. So I took FAR two times, I got 73s on each. Third time I'm taking FAR, seventh time I'm taking the CPA exam. I'm so over it, so over this exam. I got a 72. So my score got worse. At this time, I remember looking at this score. I thought this score was gonna be my passing score. My dog of 13 years just passed away. I remember looking up the score. I thought, well, maybe I'll remember this the day I got my winning score because my dog passed away. No. No. I got worse. So I specifically remember, it's a small thing sometimes, I specifically remember going to the walking track with one of my very good friends who always says small little things that helps me out. Thank you very much, Mark. I said, Mark, I was like, I just want to be done, man. Like, you know, like, I've been studying for so long. I mean, I already have a job. I just want to be done. Just want to be done. He looked at me and says, well, you're not done yet. I was like, yeah, I just had to come back because I was like, yeah, I wanted it to be done. I wasn't done yet. So there you go. Finish it out. Just be done with it. Because now I'm a few years, I passed the exam. This is about, I think, three years ago now that I'm filming this, that I stop studying for the exam. Oh, I'm sorry, let's have our triumph, right? So anyways, he said, you're not done for the exam. I signed up for another one. You have to, I couldn't take it in the same quarter. So now I had about 6 months left. If I failed this one, I could only fail it maybe, I think, this time or one more time. I'd already failed it three times. I got a 73, a 73, and then I got worse to a 72. I don't know. I'm trying to think today what happened between that seventh time, that third failure, and that eighth test, that winner. Because I'll tell you, that fourth test I retook, and I went back from the summer, and so I was June or July. August, September, so I went back there in September. That's that Big J trash life, son. Yo, some real white trash shit right here. Sorry. And I took it for the last time, the fourth and final time I took four, I passed it with a 77. Might as well have been 100 for me. Let me tell you, I was so happy. And I never had to think about that stuff anymore. A couple months later, I worked my year at the job, and I got my CPA license, and I'm a licensed CPA in the state of Florida. And just last week, I got my renewal in the mail for my CPA license. I've been a licensed CPA since January of 2015. It's October of 2017 now, so I've been a CPA for like 2 years. I just got my renewal in for I'm a licensed CPA in the state of Florida with my continuing education and all that until December 31st, 2019. Hope this motivates you. Have a blessed day. I love you guys. See you tomorrow. Yo, just got out of hair and makeup. 2 hours. I had to show up 2 hours early for hair and makeup. Right? Look at that, dude. Your barber's swagging on him, and your tattoo artist. You're gonna get another tattoo soon. I forget that that's my only tattoo and I'm not all tatted up. In my head, I'm all tatted up. I don't know what, you know, just one of those things. A daily vlogger. I have a zit right here. How am I supposed to motivate all y'all with a freaking big zit on my face? I was thinking, now, this is motivation on why you should get your CPA license. I act like a donkey, I have the dumbest haircut, I think it looks great, but everyone else, a lot of people think it looks stupid, maybe for the business world, for people to take you serious, you might not want to have this haircut. Basically, the CPA license, if you pass these exams, if you go on and persevere and actually get your license, you can act however you want and people will know that you're just acting how you're acting and you're actually very smart and very intelligent and they love to pay you to do work for them because they know how smart you are. So it's really a great equalizer. It's been a great equalizer for me because I used to be like just, you know, white trash, wigger, just what's wrong with you, and now they're like still all those things, but he's smart because of my CPA license.